Hey, Ice Flyers Nation, we're back with another episode of Ice Flyers All Access, and this is a special one, the Star Wars edition. So go ahead and fill up a glass of blue milk as we sit down with number 44, Mitch Atkins. So we're in here with number 44, Mitch Atkins. Thank you so much for stopping by today.
Great. Just jumped off for practice, feeling great. So great awesome. Day with the guys.
So Mitch, this is your first season here in Pensacola. What drew you to come play for the Ice Flyers this year?
So a few years ago, I played at the Bay Center and just loved the electric atmosphere. So that was a huge draw. We have an amazing fan support here. So that was definitely something that drew me in. A close friend of mine, Seth Enzer, I played with him before in Danville. And so he spoke incredibly highly about the organization, the championship culture here. And it was definitely something that I wanted to be a part of.
So you found success at many different levels in your hockey career. What makes you most excited about this team?
I love our depth. I think that throughout our lineup, all of our lines can play. We're really close in the team too. I really think we have a great locker room. Guys really love and care about each other, and I think that that's important. Addition to that, we have great structure, and I feel that when all those things combine, it's a recipe for success.
Now, we know that you spend a lot of time in the arena and on the road and all that, but what are those few things that you like doing when you're not here? What are your like favorite spots around town?
Yeah, the guys, we like to go to lunch at the Garden. It's a great spot after practice. A lot of different options for food, and you know, we'll come in rolling with like 10 guys, and it'll be a great spot just to sit down, you know, after a good skate and just hang out, talk to the guys, and just, you know, enjoy each other's company. So that's a fun spot for us.
Well, I'm sure now after this, you're probably gonna have to sign a few autographs because fans are gonna be staking you guys out there.
Might get, maybe don't give away all the spots, but that's a good one.
So it's Star Wars night here, which is a big night for us here at the Ice Flyers. We gotta ask you, what's your favorite Star Wars memory?
So a split question, favorite movie would be Empire Strikes Back, like from the original trilogy is definitely the best one, I think. And then favorite memory, when I was a kid with the prequels and the Phantom Menace, the Star Wars battle between Darth Maul and Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan, that's, as a kid, that for me, that was definitely the best memory. It was a sweet scene, and it was a pretty epic ending for anyone that's, I'm sure everyone's seen it, so that one's epic.
So the Star Wars franchise has stretched over multiple decades, films, TV, everything that's gone into it. It's a cultural phenomenon. What is most exciting about the future of the franchise for you?
I've watched them all. I'm just finishing up Andor here now. I think there's an episode left, but yeah, it's really cool that they've expanded. I loved Obi-Wan, I loved The Mandalorian, and some of the other ones are quality too. And so definitely The Mandalorian, that upcoming season was great, or is gonna be great, and the first couple were amazing. If they go along with any standalone films too, like I thought Rogue One was awesome too. So there's a couple things I'm sure they have in the works, but for me, those are what I'm excited about for Star Wars and their future.
All right, and finally, before we get out of here, did Han shoot first?
Han shot first.
All right, there it is. All right, we got to get this interview wrapped up before George Lucas comes and re-edits it and takes it out, so.
Mitch, thank you for sitting down with me and sharing your favorite Star Wars memories. And fans, make sure you head out to the hangar early to catch all the exclusive content here on Ice Flyers All Access. See you next time.